Hello everybody and welcome to today's video. Today I want to talk about some things that I'm so thankful for now, and after a few years of minimalism I just realized how great it is to have these things. But these are everyday things, things that I didn't waste a thought about before I became a minimalist. So I wanted to share these things with you to just show you how the little things can become really important for your life when you become a minimalist. Maybe that's totally different for you. Let me know your experience in the comments and let's get started. So the first thing I'm really thankful for is silence. I've realized that actually a few years ago and before I really became a minimalist, but it has been so much more since I've become a minimalist. And when I realized that, I was sitting in Italy on a cliff looking over the sea. We were on vacation. I didn't like it because I had to go with my family and I was listening to music like I would always do. And I realized after time that I don't want to listen to music anymore. And I put my headphones down and I enjoyed the silence. And it was so much better than any music I could have listened to. And I link you a video where I talk more about why I don't really listen to music anymore. But silence is such a great thing. I love it when I go walking in the forest and I can't hear any streets, but just maybe some birds, like the wind in the leaves. But the silence of the forest, or when I'm in the mountains, or when I'm in my room and there's nothing disturbing me. Sometimes the fridge makes little noises, but like that silence of not having always music, not always people screaming, not always people talking, but sometimes just a moment of silence and stillness. That can be a source of so much creativity, of so much like energy to me. I didn't realize that before I became a minimalist, or didn't think silence was something worth mentioning or worth like thinking about or like spending time in silence, but it's a great thing. Another thing is showers. I always loved showers, but I didn't appreciate them until I became a minimalist and thought about taking cold showers. So a lot of other people like ditching warm showers and thinking about only showering cold. And I think, yeah, maybe I could do that. Sometimes I do it, but most of the time I really, really enjoy taking hot showers. I am so thankful that we have running water that is that hot that I can take a shower, that there's enough of it, that I can take an extra 5 minutes of a shower if I want and don't have to rush because then there's not enough warm water left or something like that. I am so thankful and I enjoy showers so much. I didn't realize that. And now I realize that, oh, yeah, I would live somewhere where I can't take hot showers. But I'm super thankful that I do live somewhere where I can shower as long and as hot as I want, even though I don't want to shower too hot or too long because it's just not a sustainable thing to do. Another thing I really appreciate is our washing machine. Of course, I could wash my things by hand. People have done that for hundreds of years, but it's so convenient and it's an everyday thing. Everybody has a washing machine, or you go to a washing salon and wash your clothes there if you were living in an RV or if you just don't have a washing machine in your apartment. But I'm so thankful to have a washing machine, to have one in my apartment that I can use, and to just not, I mean, it's not even that much the washing part, but the drying part. If I try to squeeze the water out of my clothing items by hand, it's so much less efficient than if I just have them in my washing machine. Now, I hang dry all of my clothing items, so I don't have a dryer, so I'm not talking about a dryer here, but just the fact that the washing machine can turn so fast that the clothing are like half dry when they come out. That's not possible for me if I try to wash my clothing items by hand. I'm so thankful for our washing machine because it would be super hard washing all of our clothes by hand, all of our sheets and towels and stuff. We don't have a lot of laundry, but still, a washing machine makes my life so much easier. Another thing I am super thankful for is friends and human connections and like good talks in general. I have to say I don't have a huge number of friends. Also, a lot of them don't live near me And yeah, I do not have that many close friends, but just the fact that I feel at home and not stressed here. I have my boyfriend and he's my best friend. He's the person that knows me best, that I know best. And I have my son, which is another kind of relationship, but it's still a beautiful relationship. I have family that appreciates me, that lets me be the way I am most of the time. And I have some other friends that really add value to my life and that I'm so thankful for having. I'm so thankful to, yeah, I'm not afraid of people talking behind my back, even though I'm sure some people talk behind my back, but I have enough friends that I can be sure that if I need something, there is gonna be somebody somewhere that listens to me if I would need to talk, that would maybe take me in if I need to sleep somewhere. And that's like security net of friends means a lot to me. And I couldn't appreciate that a few years ago because I just didn't think about that. But now I realize I'm so, so thankful for that. Another really basic thing I'm super thankful for is for having an apartment, being able to heat it in the winter, being away from wars and other life-threatening things, just being safe here, having a safe place where there's nothing destroying my like sleep, my apartment, my belongings, my safety. I'm dry, I'm warm, I have a roof over my head, I do not have to worry about paying the rent right now. I am very, very thankful to be in a place where I can have somewhere to live and don't have to worry about that. But just, I don't take it for granted anymore because I realize that there are so many people that where it's not that easy. And I'm thankful for having an apartment. Another thing I am super thankful for is time. Of course, when I was a kid, I didn't worry about time. And then I was a teenager and I had a lot of like schoolwork to do. And I always thought I needed more time. And that hasn't really changed until now. I mean, I'm still in university. I'm just trying to write my bachelor thesis. I should be done in a few weeks. And oh, I'm so looking forward to that moment. I do not have too much time at the moment. And being a mom, and there's not too much time. But when I have some time, when I'm able to just sit somewhere and do nothing, when I'm able to go on a walk, when I'm just able to spend some time thinking or in the shower, as I mentioned before, time that is not taken up by stress and by things that I should be doing or that I just take for myself where I'm not doing things, it's so valuable. And it's so important, I think, for our health, for our mental health, and to be happy and to be like living, to know what we are going for, to reevaluate our goals. And I do not have too much time. I cannot spend days reflecting on my life, but having a little bit of time here and there is so valuable, and I'm so thankful for that. And then the last thing that maybe a lot of us don't think about, but that is really, really important, I think, and that's a foundation of almost our entire life, is health. And by that, I don't mean that not being healthy is super bad or that you cannot have a happy life. I just mean that I am so thankful for everything my body can do. I've never talked about that, but I had cancer when I was a kid. And so my health wasn't always great. But I was super lucky that everything worked out perfectly, that I'm very healthy today, that I feel that my body is healthy, that I try to eat healthy, that I try to move. I don't think I do as much of like sports as I maybe should to be perfectly healthy. But at least I'm so, so, so thankful that I don't have to take medication every day, that my body does everything I ask it to do. I can talk, I can move, I can express myself, I can see, I can like take in the whole world and be an active part and participate in like life and changing things and like doing what I want. That is so valuable. And not all of us have great health, and most of us will lose parts of it over the time. And when we get old, we are all like faced with aging and things that do not work as well as they have when we were younger. But I'm at a point where I'm so, so thankful for what my body can do, what my body has done for me so far, and just for being in this position of having this able body that can do so many things. And these things are pretty basic things, but I know that some of you or a lot of people on this planet do not have all of these things. And I wanted to share them because I think most of us actually do have these things, but we don't ever think about it. So I think it is worth thinking about very basic things that we call like normal parts of our everyday life, but actually they are a foundation to what we are able to do, to what we are able to achieve, to what we are able to like just be in this world. Another thing I want to mention is privilege. I hold a lot of privileges as a person being born in Europe, having light skin, even if I'm female and even if I was a teen mom and even if I had cancer as a kid, I still have so many privileges. And I'm thankful for these because of course they are normal for my life, but a lot of people don't have them, and a lot of people have to struggle and have to work for things I don't have to work for, and that's not right. And it's just, I am actually really, it's not good the way we handle that nowadays, that this like privilege is so unevenly spread, that some people just have privileges and others don't have them, and there's nothing they can do about it. Because it's something in our heads, because we make a system that is not fair. It's not fair, and I try to deconstruct these unfair systems. I am like, it's very important to me to work towards social justice and environmental justice, but we're not there. And until then, of course, I am angry that it isn't that way, but also I am still thankful that I have these privileges because they open so many doors for me. They make it possible to have this YouTube channel. Maybe you listen to me because I am able to speak English, because I was able to have an education where I learned to speak English. There are so many different things playing into this, and so I think it is really worth thinking about our very basic privileges and things that we have that determine what we can do with our lives. Thank you so, so much for watching, and let me know what you think about this topic. Let me know what the things are that you are really thankful for, even though they are maybe very normal and most people have them. And if you want to see more videos, I'll link you a video here and a playlist here, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!